Is diversity really important? We often hear that diversity is important, but we don't often hear why. Genetic diversity is crucial in a population because it brings different tools for population survival, while a lack of diversity typically results in problems and death. The COVID-19 pandemic is a prime example of this. If everyone were equally susceptible to the virus, we would all perish. Therefore, a lack of genetic diversity is a significant threat to the survival of any population and must be avoided. Interestingly, there is one important population in the United States that is demonstrably losing diversity over the years, potentially explaining many of the problems they face today. And I'm not talking about humans. I'm talking about honeybees. Why are honeybees dying at high rates in the United States? Why are so many problems happening to honeybees? Several scholars have concluded that the problems bees are facing today is the result of multiple variables acting together. Poor nutrition, pesticides, pests and parasites, to name a few. But the elephant in the room is always the same. Why have honeybees become so vulnerable to so many different factors in the last decades? The answer might lie in the genes of honeybees. Genetic diversity is crucial for the survival of any species on Earth. Without genetic variation, a population cannot evolve in response to changing environmental variables, which can lead to an increased risk of extinction. In nature, honeybees are one of the best at producing genetic diversity for their own survival. To ensure honeybees' survival for millions of years on this planet, a powerful reproductive system was shaped by natural selection to guarantee high genetic diversity wherever honeybees are found in the world. Honeybees have the highest mutational rates among higher eukaryotes. To increase diversity even further, the honeybee queen mates with dozens of drones, resulting in a huge genetic diversity among the members of the honeybee colony. This genetically diverse population ensures that there are options in case the environment changes, a new disease appears, or any other problems arises. This is the reason honeybees have survived well for millions of years on this planet. However, this might not be the case in the United States anymore. In 2023, Dr. Mohamed Alburaki and colleagues published a comprehensive genetic analysis of the honeybee population in the United States. Dr. Alburaki collected samples from all over the United States with the goal to provide a robust picture of the honeybee's genetic diversity, and the results were really concerning. Using molecular techniques to assess differences in mitochondrial DNA, surprisingly, almost 94% of the samples belong to a single honeybee lineage, the lineage C, known as the North Mediterranean bees, while only 3.2% belong to the lineage M, West Mediterranean bees, and the remaining samples belong to lineage A, African bees. In 1993, Schiff and Shepard discovered that 77% of feral honeybees samples across 9 US states belong to the C lineage as well. And 11 years later, in 2014, researchers from the University of Arkansas found that 83% of the samples belong to the C lineage. And now, in 2023, we have almost 94% of the samples belong to the same lineage. Apparently, the incidence of lineage C is increasing in the United States, while all other lineages are disappearing. What is the reason for the increasing prevalence of the North Mediterranean lineage in the United States? The North Mediterranean region of Southeast Europe is home to several well-defined subspecies of honeybees, including Ligustica, Carnica, Macedonica, Cecropia, and Cypria. Among these subspecies, Ligustica and Carnica are the most historically imported and common in the US. The Carnolian bee is the most abundant subspecies, indicating a significant circulation of Carnolian queen stocks. Four haplotypes C2J, C2C, C2D, and C2I are represented, with the great majority being C2J. Interestingly, haplotype diversity among European populations is completely different from the US populations, showing a higher diversity in European honeybee populations. To understand what's happening, we need to go back in time. First, the Western honeybee species Apis mellifera is not native to the United States of America. The first honeybee colonies were imported from Europe in the early 1600s for economic purposes. Therefore, only a small portion of the genetic diversity found in Europe the native area of Apis mellifera was brought to America. Furthermore, many US beekeepers conducted massive breeding programs across the country in search for more profitable production systems. Their self-preservation biases selected economically important lineages without necessarily considering whether these lineages were the best suited for survival in nature. The introduction of varroa mites around 40 years ago has worsened the situation for bees and genetic diversity. Varroa mites have led beekeepers to search for genetic traits that could give bees an advantage in fighting the parasite. This has resulted in an increased selection of specific lineages from the already genetically poor population, which may further limit genetic diversity. Maintaining wild population of honeybees is crucial for generating the necessary genetic diversity to adapt to different conditions in nature. However, due to the ever-increasing commercial selection, some scholars argue, myself included, that the majority of bees found in the wild today in the United States are actually swarms from commercial beekeeping operations. This limits the potential for true wild populations to adapt and generate the necessary genetic diversity needed to help honeybees in the United States. This lack of genetic diversity very likely is responsible for part of the high colony losses observed in the United States. And unfortunately, after working with commercial beekeepers for more than a decade, I have to say that the problem lies on lack of knowledge, fear of change, and a bit of greed. Many commercial beekeepers struggle to understand natural selection and how genetic diversity arises. They insist on keeping certain practices that focus only on economic aspects of the selection process. If a new stock of bees is able to survive well under today's conditions, but does not provide beekeepers with all economic benefits they are used to, then that particular honeybee stock might not be welcome. In order for honeybees to thrive and adapt to new changes in their environment, true wild bees must be allowed to generate the new genes necessary for their survival. These new stocks for sure will be a little different from what beekeepers are used to, and perhaps inconvenient compared with the current beekeeping practices. Perhaps honeybees might need something more than just produce a lot of honey, swarm less, or any other feature important for old generation beekeepers. It is time to stop focusing on the symptoms and start to address the cause of the problem. Honeybees are one of the most successful societies in natural history because of their ability to adapt to new conditions. If you view adaptation and change as inconveniences, I'm sorry to say, but you're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem. Dr. Alburaki has accepted my invitation for a live stream to discuss this issue and explore ways to improve the genetic diversity of honeybees in the United States. He'll be appearing on a show soon. If you're interested in learning more about this event, please sign up to my email list, link in the description of this video. This is a difficult problem that requires a lot of communication, and it will definitely demand many more videos like this. Since you made to the end, I assume you enjoyed this content and would like to see more of this. If so, I invite you to become a patron of the show. With a small monthly donation, you can help me to create more of these videos for everyone. Please visit patreon.com/insidethehivetv for more information. Watch this video to learn more about bees. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. InsideTheHive.tv, the show about bees. See you guys next week.